Okay guys, hey, what's up? You guys have been asking for a makeup tutorial for quite some time, so I am finally gonna do one, and we're starting with our primer. We use Professional from Benefit, and I'm taking my damp beauty blender, and I'm just putting some of the product right on, and I am just going to beat it over. And I've already put on my serum and my moisturizer for the day. Okay, so I'm actually gonna do my eyes first, and I'm gonna go ahead and start with my MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. I'm gonna use my Morphe applicator brush, E64. Look how nice this brush is. It's a little bit dirty because I have used this with my paint pot. And what I do is just for overall base, I just paint that right all over the lid. This is gonna brighten up any of your eyeshadows you put on and make sure that it stays. We love that. Look at how smooth and flawless that already is, you guys. Hello, honey. Okay, so we're gonna use the new BH Naughty palette. Look how beautiful all of these colors are, you guys. For my overall base color, I am gonna use meringue. I usually just use like a beigey neutral. And I'm just gonna put that right over my paint pot. Look at that pigment, honey. Minimal fallout, that is what I'm talking about. And I just kind of paint that all over the lid. See? So now I'm gonna go ahead and use Mealed for my transition color. It's just an orangey color. I'm using a blending brush from Morphe, and I'm just gonna go in and set my crease. And I just kind of like blend that out as I am laying down the color. Super pigmented, was not expecting it, so I kind of like went in a little bit too hard probably. It's okay, it's gonna be that kind of a look. It's gonna be a little bit more dramatic than I was gonna go for, but we're here for it. And I'm just gonna keep blending that out. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and put Candy Cane into my crease and not blend it up too far with my transition that I have already set. I'm gonna take another blending brush from Morphe. Ooh, this picks up so much pigment, you guys. This is a pigmented palette, and I'm just going to be careful because I know that it is pigmented, and kind of just set it right here in the corner of my crease. You see that? I'm gonna do the exact same for the other side, and I am just pressing it in. I am not blending, I am pressing it in. Do not wanna blend this, not yet. Okay. Look at that pigment. Okay, Candy Cane, yes. See that, pressing it in, so key. All right, so I'm gonna go in with this dark color here called Brick. I'm gonna do the exact same thing. It's going to add some depth to what we just did. I'm just laying that darker pigment down right now. Ooh, it's very berry. This side is already transforming. So notice I'm still doing my dabbing motion. I am kind of blending right here. Again, I'm not taking it up far. That's not my goal. So I am gonna take the Morphe M532. This is a very soft blending brush. Start blending this out a little bit. Just slightly, because we still want this look to be bold. Look at it, it's already blended so nicely. I love this harsh line, but we have to blend it. I am just doing it right along the line of that darker color and the transition color. See, we don't want to blend it out too much because it will get too crazy. We want to control this. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna go in with our darkest color, which is Nutcracker right here, this guy. again, just dabbing that into the corner of our eye. You see that? Just dabbing a little bit. Don't make it too crazy. Messy, but it's only because we're going to blend. Going back in with our blender brush, and we're going to soften that up a little bit. Don't dare do anything else, honestly. Okay, so I'm going to use my color switch and get this darker pigment off of my brush, just in this circular motion here. Look at that. So bomb. Okay, so we're gonna go back in with our flat applicator brush, going in with our base color meringue, and we're going to just cut the crease a little bit. So, I'm just gonna press that pigment onto our lid. Look at that. Just brightens the eye. So I'm gonna go in with their Lump of Coal liquid black eyeliner. Okay, I've never used this. Please bear with me. Okay, she's transforming. Okay, now I'm gonna use the BH Bliss Lash Mascara. I always do mascara before I put my lashes on, just so that they blend better. I'm using Lily Lashes in Hollywood. And so I have placed my Duo brush on in dark adhesive onto my lash strip, and then I just let it kind of set a little bit so that it's nice and tacky when I'm placing the lash on. I use my little Tarte tool right here to place the lashes on. And I just let it dry. Then I do the same thing on the other side. Okay. Nice and fluttery. We applied them at the perfect time because they're nice and tacky. And I just take the tool and I just kind of press my real lash with my strip lash just to make it sure it blends. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and finish up our face. I'm using my MAC Studio Fix foundation. I'm gonna put it right onto my beauty blender. And I do this after my eyes because, first of all, I didn't know the product until today. Because once there's a lot of fallout and you already have your foundation, this is a very powerful, full coverage foundation, that fallout could stick. And I just dab in my foundation all over my face, take it down to my neck so that it blends. So I'm gonna take some of my shape tape and just lay my concealer right underneath my eye and down the bridge of my nose, right here, cover some of those acne scars, hello. And then just make sure that that's nice and blended with our Beauty Blender. Foundation application is just like so much more flawless, and it really truly makes it look like it's your real skin. So I'm taking my Mented Brow Down High Precision brow pencil. I love Mented over the Leading pencil because the product is so much more pigmented, lays down so much smoother. Highly recommend it. My arch and my eyebrow is always darker, so right here is the darkest point. And make sure that right here is the lightest point. And I just brush that out so that it blends. Okay, and I'm adding in my brow setter gel from Benefit. Look how sharper this eyebrow already looks than this one, because we haven't put the gel on this one yet. It just sharpens up the entire brow. See that? You're wise. So now I'm just gonna go in with my MAC Studio Fix powder. I always set my creams with powder. I know a lot of people do either or, but I just do the most. And usually I do cream contour too, but today I'm just gonna do powder contour. So I'm gonna take my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. I'm gonna take my little vintage Estee Lauder brush right there. I love this brush, you guys. Very retro, very 90s. My mom gave this to me a long time ago and I still use it almost daily. Okay, and then I'm just going to take an actual bronzer brush and just kind of round that out. How nice that looks. And then because I had double chins for days, I always take the Shade Light palette from KVD Vegan Beauty, and I take this really ashy tone right here in the palette and I just kind of put it underneath and I blend everything down. See, it already has sculpted my chin. Just make sure that that's very blended. So now that we have our powders set and laid down, I'm gonna use the Let It Glow palette. I'm using their fan brush in one. And I'm gonna go ahead and use this nice champagne color here called Tinsel. Dab my fan brush into it. And just do a little bit down the bridge of my nose. And wow, that's so pretty. This is a really, really pretty palette. And I'm just gonna take a little smudge brush and actually dip into some of that Tinsel and put it in the corner of my eye because it's so pretty. Oh my, you better just stop. Put a little bit right there on my brow bone. Oh, all right. It's coming along, guys. I'm gonna take my smudge brush again, go back into my Muled transition color. Make sure it's nice and tapped so that you don't get any fallout. And I'm just gonna go right underneath my lash line, my lower lash line. And I always wait to do this for the end because I don't want any fallout. And I wanna make sure that when I'm doing my concealer, I can get right underneath my eyes so I don't mess up any look that I've done previously. So it's kind of giving us that smoked out look now. And I'll usually go back in with my mascara and do the bottom lashes. Last but not least is lips. So we're gonna go ahead and go in with the House Laboratories lip liner in Myth and just line our lips. And then I just do a little bit of blending. Blend it down a little bit. And then we're going to take the Cashmere Cream Lipstick in Shook from the BH Holiday Collection. And we're gonna put her right on top, honey. It's so creamy. So this is our final look, you guys. A little holiday glam using the new BH Holiday Collection. I hope you guys like this. Let me know what you think and let me know what you guys want to see next.